Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So as you can see by the title, today I'm gonna talk about the trends, the things, the people, the movement, the higginess that we need to leave behind in 2017. For years now, I've seen many types of videos like this done by Grace Ajulore, Jackie Aina, Nella Rose, like loads of people have done these kinds of videos. So I thought, let me also add my own name into the list, you get what I'm saying? Because I've got a lot to talk about. The first thing we need to leave behind in 2017 is the rinsing of songs. Like, even I'm guilty to this. Like, I feel like our generation, once we find a banging song, we will rinse it everywhere. It'll be in every wedding, every Snapchat, every Instagram story, even on Facebook Live, they'll be playing the tune. Like, we actually need to let it go. Sometimes it'll get to a point where I've never even listened to the song, but because I've heard it on everybody's Snapchat in every single rave, I know the song from beginning to end. But these times I've never even typed up the song. I don't even know the song lyric. I don't even know the song itself. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying the songs haven't been banging. They've been banging. However, the artist has not died yet. Do you get what I'm saying? They will still release song in 2018. So let's please be patient. Another thing we should leave behind in 2017 is jumping closure, jumping frontal. Your wig is high top. Do you get what I'm saying? Open book closure, closed destiny closure, skyscraper, ladder reaching to Jesus wig. We don't want it in 2018, okay? Obviously, I understand us girls, we can't be slaying 24/7, but there are some girls that think that that is the way the wig should be standing, as in their wig is higher than their future and their destiny. Better say, God forbid, God forbid. I want you to go to the mirror and take a look at your wig. If your wig is reaching Jesus more than you're reaching Jesus, then there needs to be a transformation. Do you get what I'm saying? Your relationship with God should be greater than your wig is with heaven. You know what? Something needs to change about my hair. Oh, that's better. Oh God, wow. Mountain top. I feel like the higher my hair is, the more my face looks slimmer actually. So I'm loving this look. Oh, look at it. I love the way my wig is so high. Wow, Jesus, hear me. It really makes my face look slimmer, deep, because the higher the wig is, the slimmer my face is. Another thing we should leave behind in 2017 is the men are trash movement. Like, I'm sick and tired of hearing men are trash, men are trash, men. Even men are saying men are trash. I'm just confused right now. I understand that some men are trash, but some women are trash. Human beings can be trash. Do you get what I'm saying? But I don't understand why it's all of a sudden a movement. Yeah, you know. I really believe there's power in the tongue. So keep on saying that men are trash. You marry dustbin. Your first son will be Dustbin Junior. That's your destiny if you keep on saying men are trash. Instead of you to be praying to God saying, God, let me find the one, let me find correct Bobo, you're saying men are trash. You're doing threads on Twitter. How would that change your life? How would that change your destiny? Because at the end of the day, the thing is, people that are tweeting out men are trash, they're cuddled up with their babe at home. Do you get? So you girls, don't be deceived. These girls have man them at home. They are loved up, they are wifed. Do you get what I'm saying? But you're there saying, oh yeah, that's true, men are trash. and you're there single. But as they say, trash knows trash. So as you see, I'm so you be. So if you keep on attracting trash people, then you kind of need to check within yourself if there is trash mentalities residing and dwelling within your spirit. Another thing we need to leave behind is when guys get a tattoo or new earring or new pinky or new gold tooth and they don't know how to close their mouth. So every day shining, shining, shining on Snapchat. Like it's actually not by force, you know. For example, a guy would get a tattoo on his arm. In every chance, you see that arm appear in every single snap. Like, oh guy, we do not want to see the name of your mother. Okay, it's enough. Obviously, it's cost a couple grand. Like what, man's got the money. Easy, yeah, man, sick and all that. No. Obviously, they're interchangeable, and that you get me, yeah. Hey, what's up, darling? What you telling me? Huh? I love the fact that black girls are now rocking blonde hair. Like before, people say no, black girls, dark skin girls, they can't do this, they can't wear that, they can't. No, who told you we can do anything we wanted to? Okay, the issue comes about when girls get a blonde or platinum frontal and then you see the black edge screaming. The edges are creeping and they're crawling. I feel like the hairdresser you go to makes a big difference as well. It's not that you can't rock it, but the hairdresser that you have is underqualified in that particular era. Do you get what I'm saying? So I feel like if you want to go blonde and all platinum, then you need to have the correct hairdresser and your edges need to be receding behind the wig. And I know that some people may say black girls shouldn't wear blonde hair, black girls don't look good with blonde hair. I just feel like maybe you should tell your mom to stop wearing gold lipstick with black eyeliner around it, and then maybe we can come to some kind of negotiation, you know. But as long as your mom still looks like that, I can look however I want to look. Another thing that should be left behind, and this irritates me so much, is when a Caucasian person does something black, right? And then a black person's like, yeah, you're now invited to the cookouts, yeah, you're now black, yeah, you can now say the N-word. I'm just thinking, did you realize when you say stuff like that, you're not helping the issue that's already going on in this world? Like, racism is already at its all-time peak, and now you're saying, oh yeah, yeah, you white person, you can say the N-word, and you're allowed to be with us black people because you can do the whip. What's that? Like, can we all grow up, please? Thank you. I feel like black people need to get out the mindset that white people can't do black people things. Like, it's not only black people that can dance. Do you get what I'm saying? White people can dance as well. White people can learn an African language and sing in that language. Like, it's not hard. Like, it's not hard, you know? Well, that's the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any other things that we should leave behind in 2017, please write them down below. I wanna laugh tonight. Hope you guys like my little wig collection lookbook kind of thing going on. Guys, please excuse the dead trim and the lack of color on my roots. Like, yeah, going through a lot right now. Once again, happy new year, guys. This year is gonna be amazing. Like, obviously we're gonna go through some stuff, it's inevitable, but God is gonna see us through, and at the end of it all, we're gonna come and testify and say, yes, 2018 was the year that my life changed for the better. Do you get what I'm saying? And that is all of your testimony in Jesus' name. Ami Lurka Jesus. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. See ya!